everyone, my name is Shayla Kennell, and the book I decided to do for my reading log 6 is called A Bike Like Sergio's by Maribeth Boltz, illustrated by Noah Z. Jones. So A Bike Like Sergio's is about a young boy named Ruben who more than anything wants a bike, but his family cannot afford many things, especially a bike. So our main character Ruben, he's the only kid without a bike in the story, and the story contains mostly characters such as Ruben and Sergio. Sergio is the one with the bike, and Ruben is the one that is not, that doesn't have the bike. And at the beginning of the story, it just explains how Ruben is always having to run alongside Sergio because he doesn't have a bike. And throughout the story, Sergio, his friend, was basically just saying, why don't you ask again for a bike? And Ruben is basically saying, maybe, but little does Sergio know about Ruben's situation and how he can't afford a bike. So he kind of just brushes it off. So one day, Sergio and Ruben are going to the local market, or the local grocery store, aka Sunny's grocery store, and Ruben is standing in line behind a lady in a purple coat. He's kind of a little angry because he sees his friend Sergio buying baseball cards, and he knows in the back of his mind that he cannot afford, you know, even the simplest thing like baseball cards. So he's kind of angry as he's just holding, you know, a loaf of bread that his mom asked him to buy. And as they were leaving the store, the lady in front of him actually ends up dropping in what Ruben thinks a dollar bill. But when he gets home, it actually turns out to be a $100 bill. So basically throughout the story, Ruben is trying to figure out, you know, if he's going to return the money or if he's going to keep the money. And, you know, it also shows throughout the story how, you know, it explains how the $100 bill is more than what the bike cost. And, you know, Ruben dreams about the bike. But at the end of the story, the author, Maribeth Boltz, creates a theme of, you know, she creates a thing of doing the right thing is always best. And what Ruben did was he returned the money at the end of the story because that was the best thing to do. So, in my personal experience, I've actually had that happen to me when I was going to school at Tarrant County College. I actually dropped a $20 bill at the campus bookstore when I was buying Scantrons to take a test for school, and I didn't realize that I lost a $20 bill until I went to go fill up my car. And the next morning I got to school, you know, I was devastated, of course, that's a lot of money. And the next day I got to school, one of my colleagues had actually came up to me and returned the money. He said he wasn't gonna spend it because he saw it come from my purse. So he said he wasn't gonna spend the money and he returned it to me. And I was overjoyed, of course, but you know, it was the same theme as, you know, A Bike Like Sergio's. So that is my presentation on my reading log.